Hello, welcome to the third part of our lecture, Governance in the Digital Age, the State of Affairs, Opportunities and Challenges for the Board of Directors. In this video, we will understand how boards' involvement in the strategy and risk are changing due to digital technologies and this new environment. We will understand what it means to build a resilient board and the need for building just-in-time strategies and how the board of directors can do that. It's very important to understand that what leadership doesn't know or fails to know or act upon can hurt tremendously a company. Take, for example, the willful violation of emission standards that resulted in more than 30 lawsuits, a 40% drop in stock value, and the removal of the CEO at Volkswagen. Or consider how 5 public pension funds have joined a lawsuit against officers and directors of Wynn Resorts Limited. The allegation of board members were aware of former CEO Steve Wynn's ongoing sexual misconduct, including harassment, abuse, and assault of employees, but failed to act upon. In a recent NACD survey, 86% of board respondents indicated that they fully expect to deepen their engagement with management on new drivers of growth and risk in the next 5 years. This deeper, more proactive is far from easy to implement. In fact, it means the board moving from being a passive monitor and overseer of the business to be more actively engaged and challenge management thinking, and when appropriate, acting as partner with management in order to effectively respond to new strategic challenges. The risk is that this new model of engagement may spill over into micromanagement by the board or cause undue tension between the board and the management team. Therefore, a strong leadership and a healthy CEO chair relationship is needed to avoid the pitfalls of this new approach and keep board members overseeing and more proactive in providing direction and shaping the future strategy. This new involvement of the board with management will require better access to information about the business and external trends, including from sources independent of managers and increasingly generated by advanced analytical techniques and tools that equip the board to quicker spot issues. By definition, a more engaged posture will also place new demands on board members' team, as board engagement can no longer just happen to a quarterly meeting, but must become a continuous process. With boards tasked to take ownership of a growing roster of risks, directors have been tasked to up their skills, risk management skills, sooner rather than later. Rising to the fore are cyber threats, which have exploded since 2017. Cyber attacks have grown increasingly sophisticated, as have the regulations enacted in response to these new threats. For example, the EU General Data Protection Regulations, enacted in May 2018, to unify regulation in the EU around data privacy, had significant security and compliance implications for companies around the world. Violations could potentially cost a company as much as 4% of its annual revenue in fines. In the security realm, Wall Street analysts can now evaluate company cyber risks ratings, which use a score to communicate a company's vulnerability to a data breach through tools like BitSight and Security Scorecard. Therefore, boards and management need to work together to take action timely. That said, approaching risk and merely an issue of compliance is insufficient. Traditionally, it seems a compliance focus would be ideal for risk management by emphasizing formalized processes, adding more independent directors, and utilizing online tools for compliance requirements such as online resolutions, voting, minutes, and board evaluations. But even these tactics won't catch or address all risks. If directors are asking questions but are still getting all the answers from management, they can miss important sites if management is the problem in the first place. Therefore, directors of leading organizations take a more proactive role, assuming strategic partnerships or even coaching relationships with executive team management. They are seeking out the big picture with information from third-party sources. They are asking detailed questions and challenging the answers, particularly if short-term gains come with increased risk. They are better positioned to catch and address risks in today's volatile, uncertain, complex, and evolving environment. Boards increasingly understand this, that cyber is a risk management issue that affects the whole organization and requires board oversight, and they need to view cybersecurity as an enterprise risk, not an IT topic with regular briefings by management or critical updates, progress, changes, and challenges along the way. There are evidence that boards increasingly understand their role in oversight, requirements for budget and staffing, and the need for a regular cadence and framework with management. Boards are bringing cyber experts to explain technology, best practices, and educate directors on their responsibility and preparedness. Just to give you a dimension of the importance of cybersecurity, up to 88% of UK companies have suffered breaches in the last 12 months. One small business in the UK is successfully hacked every 19 seconds, and around 65,000 attempts to hack small to medium-sized businesses occur in the UK every day, around 4,500 of which are successful. Cisco estimates 53% of SMEs suffered a security breach globally in 2018. Data breaches cost UK enterprises an average of 3.88 million per breach, according to IBM and Ponemon's cost of a data breach study. So, the rule of thumb is be ready for anything because it will probably happen. Directors who have the fiduciary responsibility for health of their organizations are part of the response to tackle this problem. They need to make sure that they can answer the following questions and work with management in a timely, effective plan. A board in the digital age needs to be able to answer the following questions. How would your organization know if an attack hit? How would you know that your systems have been compromised? What would the damage be to your operations if access to your data was unavailable for a period of days or weeks? And who would be responsible for communicating with regulators, media, employees, customers, investors, and stakeholders? And just one more, how would you minimize the impact of business and the bottom line? So, as you can see, cybersecurity is only one of all the elements of digital technologies that have a strong and serious impact on board members' way of thinking and work. The speed of change in today's world is quickly. So, adaptability is crucial for boards to keep relevant and make valuable contributions. Let's just think about all the changes and digital disruptions just in the 21st century. Business-to-business models shifting from brick-and-mortar to e-commerce. The emergence of social media networks with implications for consumer marketing, sales models, and reputation management. Or the impacts of big data that we talked. Increased pressure on companies to consider environmental and social impact, And now, the ESG agenda, environmental, social, and governance. And the new generation of consumers with different values, preferences, and buying habits. The average tenure of a CEO in the job of the 100 FTSE is 5.4 years, while it is forecasted that half of the companies listed in the S&P 500 will be replaced in the next 10 years. Either they can go bankrupt, get acquired, or struggle and shrink, mostly because of failure to embrace technological disruption. And this is a topic particularly challenging for board members. As the board of directors assume a broader role in accelerating world and heavy stewardship suggested, the concept of resilient board emerges as a solution and suggestion to boards to look closer to their companies. Performance level infrastructure and composition to better understand and spot changes that may be necessary in terms of capabilities and capacities. Having operated in an environment of corporate volatility for over a decade, today's boards are recognizing the need to adjust their usual ways of doing things. For example, a 5-year plan, which may be obsolete in 18 months, are shifting to a more agile approach to decision making. And this is all about to keeping up with the velocity of change by bringing on diversity directors and training directors to actually look for marketing dynamics, because even a successful business like GE or Toyota can suddenly find they become irrelevant. Directors must look at to their companies and ask if they will become the next blockbuster video or Kodak, because their companies are dismissing new business models. Although plans are necessary, it is not enough. The board of directors need to make sure they and their companies have infrastructure to deal with crisis situations. Many businesses were not prepared for a crisis like the one caused by coronavirus, but businesses like Microsoft, Amazon, and many other digital businesses increased their sales substantially in this moment, because they were digitally prepared. Those that were not, they had to make things in 3 months that would have done in 3 years. Many of necessary changes in processes, culture, and structures fails due to the conflicts of interest inside the board of directors and poor oversight, and the reasons for that varies. A strong board culture requires a growth mindset, which emphasizes lifelong learning and embracing failures as opportunities for growth. In terms of processes, director evaluations can be one powerful tool for building board resilience. As we have performance management tools for employees become more frequently, rather than just once a year, maybe the same thing could happen with board performance feedback. Poor performance in the board can seriously damage shareholders and companies in a volatile environment. And, according to advisory and executive search company Russell Reynolds, activist investors are expected to increase their scrutiny of director performance as they continue to influence board decision-making, process, and composition. A board evaluation process needs to measure the right things. Some suggestions are preparedness to act, expertise, ability to accurately assess concerns related to local and international laws. Additionally, there are online resources available for strengthening facilitation, refining formats, and putting board evaluation results into action. Another important aspect of board members is to continuously self-educate and improve. Sounds trivial, but it's very important to emphasize that importance of proactive learning, such as listening to earnings calls from competitors, read analyst reports, and look for resources that come from futurists as Mary Meeker, and events such as Innovation Summit and resources like MIT. In other words, directors can't be passive receptacles of what their companies share. The second element of a board resilience is suggested to be board performance. As the pace of change is accelerating, it is important to boards to be open to different perspectives. For example, rethinking their meetings, having hundreds of pages to read without any previous analysis is not an option for the digital transformation that demands distributing just the right amount of information at the right time and empowering real-time decision-making. For example, Netflix has implemented a new way of getting more from their board meetings. A few days before a meeting, board members receive a short online memo for self-directed study that generally takes 4 to 6 hours to absorb. Directors can ask questions and comment within the electronic document before and during the meeting. Executives can answer questions and amend the text as needed. Other companies have changed course similarly. Another element to this is empower stronger decision-making year-round, meaning online tools can make information easy to find and decisions easy to track. And the tools used to exchange information, reports, and communication between board members must be secure. The last element of suggested resilient board is the board composition. And ideally, boards should represent a different set of voices, meaning backgrounds, skill sets, and experience. This will allow board of directors understanding on how members arrived at a given decision, leading to a beneficial result and even more valuable. Greater board diversity is becoming a must rather than a nice to have in an era of the Me Too movement, activist investors, and stricter diversity instances by large institutional investors. Investment managers are calling for greater transparency on ethnicity, diversity on boards, as almost 3/4 of FTSE 100 companies failed to report the ethnic makeup of their boards in these years. Investors have previously asked companies to include information on the ethnic makeup of their boards alongside gender diversity in their annual reports, with FTSE 100 boards expected to have at least one director from an ethnic minority background by 2021, under the government-sponsored Parker Review. This lack of information is preventing investors from holding companies to account on their progress. Investors expect companies not just to state whether they meet the Parker Review targets, but to disclose the percentage of the board that comes from an ethnic minority background. Another acronym is emerging to define a company's value, which is ESG, that stands for Environmental, Social and Governance. Almost half of UK investors, 48%, expect to increase their environmental, social and governance investments over the next 3 years. That was the conclusion of research from online investment platform Charles Stanley Direct, which also found that 1 in 6 UK investors, or 17%, plan to increase their ESG investments significantly. The report also found that among UK adults with an investment portfolio, 43% say they have exposure to either socially responsible investing or ESG. Issuers' ESG performance on subjects such as resource use, human rights, health and safety, corruption, and transparency is increasingly used to draw conclusions about the quality of their management, identify their exposures to business risks, and assess their ability to leverage business opportunities. Therefore, it is becoming more and more important for companies and other issuers to communicate with investors clearly and accurately on these aspects of their performance. Sustainability factors such as climate change or demographic impact companies' operating environments. It is therefore critical that companies provide a clear strategic view on the likely impact of such trends or factors on their business models. This will allow investors to understand how they are positioned and provide confidence that they are resilient and can, where possible, exploit opportunities from changing environment. A number of the world's largest investors are allocating additional capital to companies that have higher green revenue exposure or are better equipped to fulfill sustainable goals. An example is a group of Harvard Business School found that securities scoring higher in terms of exposure to companies with ostensibly good ESG ratings that tended to post higher analyzed returns. In this environment, boards are focusing on developing processes, structures, and tools to mobilize and coordinate efforts. Where can boards start to get ahead of change and shareholder expectations? Integrating both financial and non-financial performance requires leadership and support from the board and senior management. They play a central role in integrating sustainability into the business strategies overseen, implementation across the business and communicating to investors. For example, last year, Shell, one of the largest companies, linked its executive pay to its carbon emission targets in direct response to particular shareholders, including the British government. This is evident of significant and real change led by the regulator in the UK. Technology can help in this sense with information sharing, collaboration, and decision making are all means of communication that can be more transparent by technology, and having a centralized place to find the latest information helps directors stay on top of the issues and the relevant corporate messages. I choose three specific areas that shall be highlighted in the annual reports, which can demonstrate the attention of board of directors to the modern ESG, environmental, social, and governance of companies. The first one is investors often want to understand whether business can successfully respond to climate change risks, demonstrate future viability and resilience, and achieve cost savings through efficiencies and identify opportunities through green revenue opportunities. Key sources of investments, risk, and opportunity are regulatory, standards, tax, carbon pricing, and market, reduced demand for high carbon goods, products, and services, and decreased capital availability for high carbon products. And market as well, increased demand for low carbon goods, products, and services. The capital, increased capital availability for low carbon services and technologies. And the weather, natural disasters, and resource risks. Board oversight of climate change can be demonstrated through evidence of board or board committee oversight of the management of climate change risks, named positions responsible at board level. And the second item would be tax transparency. Investors often want to understand whether business can not only comply with tax arrangements, but also have a strong governance process and transparency around their tax policies and their arrangements, and as well demonstrate commitment to transparency by engaging with stakeholders and the public to communicate their contribution to local economies. The key sources of investment risk and opportunity are regulatory risks of increased regulation, which could close particular tax arrangements referred to by some as loopholes, which would mean reduced margins and profitability of particular companies. In some cases, it may even affect a company's ability to operate in certain markets. And reputational, increased is scrutiny of corporate tax behavior. Broad has oversight of tax policy can be demonstrated by evidence of board oversight of management of tax risks, named position responsible at board level. ESG is a new agenda and relevant, and several investors and fund managers are excluding companies that cannot meet the basic criteria defined by the UK government around ESG. Digital transformation has a direct influence in this, as the speed of communication and broadly access to information calls for more transparency. Therefore, it's a team that must be led by the board and needs to become a company's culture that will follow together with digitalization, challenges and opportunities. This heads us to one more big question. Are you ready? It is suggested by some authors to use tools to mind the gaps and test assumptions about the board, such as creating a matrix to provide a full view of the board's skills and knowledge, merge and acquisition experience, views on emerging markets, knowledge of generational or demographic trends, and ability to identify and mitigate risks. If the board is looking for cybersecurity experts, for example, it is important to understand the types of business questions the board wants to address and find an expert in these areas to help. Someone who understands how to protect networks might not be the right person for harnessing technological innovation for competitive advantage. In summary, building board resilience for the digital transformation requires put the structures and processes in place to spot risks before they become crises. Conduct annual anonymous evaluations whether they are required or not. Always seek to self-educate and improve. Digitalize the board meetings and bring diverse voices to the board table. At this point, you may be able to reflect and try to find an answer to this big question. If we were to create a board from scratch today, what it look like holistically? From the standpoint of skills, leadership, styles and backgrounds, what will you need in 3, 5 or more years? I would like to know your answers to that. So thank you and see you in the next video.